apartment buildings. So you're familiar with the New York building code. You know, the one that states the walls have to be just thick enough that you can hear exactly what happens in the next apartment. And we always do. We don't try to listen. We just can't help it. I mean, we overheard a conversation between a man and woman next door to us. This conversation didn't go something like this. It went exactly like this.
I hate you.
You hate me? I hate you.
You don't know what hate is, the kind of hate I have for you.
Listen, my hate for you is such a hate, such a hot hate. I hate you with hot heaping hunks of hate.
The heat of your hot hate could not begin to approximate the hateful hatredness with which I'm hatefully hating you right now.
I want to know something. If it was possible to write the word hate on each grain of sand in the Sahara Desert, all that hate on each of those hateful grains would equal 1/1,000,000th of the hate that I'm hating you with right now.
You know how much you hate me?
Yeah.
Double it. That's my hate for you.
I used to love you. Now I hate love.
How long have you hated me?
2 years.
I've hated you 4 years.
I hated you before I met you.
I hated you before you were born.
I hate your grandmother.
I hate your great-grandmother.
I hate your great-great-great-grandmother.
I hate Columbus for discovering America and making it possible for me to hate you the way I'm hating you right now.
You know, the word hate
the
is
word
a big
hate. The language of hate. Go out into space.
I really hate you.
Venus, Mars, the Milky Way, all the hate and all those planets cannot begin to show the hate that I'm hating you with right now. I'd like to ask one question. Do you think this marriage can be saved?
Are you kidding? This is the flop of the century, this marriage.
Great. Let's get a divorce.
Oh, nothing to make me happier than a divorce.
What a waste.
8 years down a drain.
8 long, miserable, rotten years gone forever.
When I think of what I gave up because of you.
What you gave up?
Yes, what I gave up.
I was a young...
Stupid.
Innocent.
Ignorant.
Naive.
Dumb. Dummy, dumb, dumb.
Kid.
Punk, that's what you were. That's what
I was a punk,
be,
huh?
A punk.
I was
when
a punk.
When I think of the chances I had and I took you.
What chances did you have?
Are you kidding? I have plenty of chances.
What chances did you have?
Eugene Gagliano worshipped the ground I walked on.
That spaghetti bender, you're going to bring him up again?
What did you call him?
You bring him
what
up again.
What did you say he was? Spaghetti
you,
what?
You
oh,
bring
are you ignorant?
Him up again.
You dare to make an ethnic remark
you.
During Brotherhood Week.
Forget about that already,
you
will
don't
you?
Know nothing,
I don't know
you
nothing, huh?
Matzo head.
You talk like that to me?
You heard it.
You shillelagh shiksa, you. You got the nerve to say a thing like that to me, huh?
Was that a shiksa?
You
I'll give
say
you shiksa.
That to me,
you don't
huh?
know shiksa you... from Shinola.
I know I'm a sugar and a Mother McCree when I see one.
Oh,
that's one
yeah.
thing. I can
you,
tell you that
you
right now, you.
You, Bensonhurst Glintz, that's what you are.
That's a low and bigoted
yeah,
remark, you.
Bigoted.
You Kalani klutz, you.
Don't
you got the nerve to say
me.
That to me, you?
You? Tel Aviv Tumla.
You Turalura Tushy, you. You got the nerve to say that to me, huh? You
that's
say
bad.
That to
you
me,
don't
huh?
know nothing.
I don't know
you
nothing, huh?
Cockamamie knish.
Look. Let's stop all this before it reaches the name-calling stage. All I want to know is one thing. What is this going to cost me?
What?
I mean, in dollars and cents, what is this going to cost me to get out of this bind?
Wait a minute. You think I want your money?
Oh, I think you want my money. I know you want my
money.
Are
you kidding? I'll pay you to get out of here.
Oh, that's great. Louis Neiser should hear this right now.
Louis Neiser. Call him up. Big deal. Legal aid. That's
You married me for my money and my artistic ability.
Your artistic
you know
ability?
Yes, my profession.
Artistic. You call painting a white line down the streets of New York artistic.
I'm creatively inclined and you discourage it, you.
You pitiful boob, oh, you civil servant. Get out.
Don't worry. I'm leaving here. You see that door?
I see that
when
door.
I go through that door, baby.
That's the closet.
Of course it's the closet, Dumbo. I was just testing you.
The last test you took was for 3B and you flunked.
All right,
remember?
That's it. I'm getting out of
get
here
your
right
coat
now.
On.
I'm leaving here right now. Where are my mittens?
They're right there. Pull down the string.
Okay. That's it. Now, you see, you just lost the last possible chance for reconciliation right then and there. I'm leaving here right now. Where's my toothbrush?
I don't know where your toothbrush is.
I cannot leave this place without the toothbrush.
Come on, break down. Buy another toothbrush.
I cannot replace the toothbrush.
Why not?
It's the one you gave me for my birthday.
You mean that toothbrush?
Yes. My Batman toothbrush.
You mean that one with the little gum massager on the end?
One that's autographed to Monroe from Batman and Robin.
Well, I had no idea you liked it so much.
It was a beautiful and touching gift, and I'll never forget you for it.
You never let on you liked it. I mean, how was I supposed to know you liked it?
It was the first time anybody ever gave me a toothbrush that matched my eyes.
It wasn't easy finding a bloodshot toothbrush. You could have said something.
Right.
You could have let me know.
All right,
Monroe.
Look. If you find the brush,
yeah,
will you send it to
me? Well, of course. I mean, that's your toothbrush.
Well, this is it.
This is it.
Goodbye, Natalie.
Monroe, wait.
What?
Look, sit down, have a cup of coffee, and then go.
Well, I really can't.
Come on, look, the coffee is warm on the stove. Just right. One cup of coffee.
All right, just one cup.
Hey, you really like that toothbrush, huh?
Well, I thought it was very thoughtful.
I'm glad, because I shopped around. It took me, yeah.
How many spoons of coffee did you put in this pot?
Oh, I put 5 spoons in a pot.
How many times have I told you, put just 4 spoons of coffee in the pot?
Well, honey, you see, there's 2 for you and 2 for me and 1 for the pot.
Well, who has to drink the coffee, me or the pot? When you make a steak, you make 1 for me, 1 for you, 1 for the oven.
Honey, I always make it that way.
Sweetheart, I always hate it that way.
You don't like the coffee?
No, I don't like the coffee.
Don't drink the coffee. Go down to the corner and get coffee.
Look, you, who's the breadwinner around here?
Breadwinner, crumb winner, that's what you
are. Oh, I hate you.
Oh, you hate me, I hate you.
You don't know what hate is.
Hello,
the kind of hate I have for you.
Hate
I hate you. Like Napoleon hates Waterloo.